Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and this is video lecture number 6, in which I am going to discuss some problems. I have already watched part 1 to part 5 before watching this part 6. In this lecture, I am in questions. So, the question left out break that I am going to discuss here, and the question number 6. So, here problems only we will discuss. Problems of exercise. Exercise 2.5 of exercise 2.5 that I am going to discuss here today. Right now, problems of exercise 2.5. Okay, problems of exercise 2.5. Question number 6. What is that? It is given that write the following cubes in expanded form. The following cubes in expanded form. So of course there are some cubes, isn't it? And the cubes are here. Sixth question is there. First question from this is given here, like 2x plus 1 whole cube. We know the formula that a cube plus a plus b whole cube is equal to, we know a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. We know that. So we will write accordingly here also. In place of a, we will put 2x. So therefore, 2x plus 1 whole cube is equal to, we will write 2x cube plus 1 cube plus, right now, plus 3 into, even you can use it, this one also, because it will take 2 steps. I have written it directly. You will write this one because for you it will be easier, I think so. 3 times of a into b. Here a is what? 2x, and b is what? 1. And now a plus b, so 2x plus 1. So that will be 8x cube plus 1. 3 to ja 6x multiply by 2x plus 1. So it will be 8x cube plus 1 plus 6x into 2x, that is 12x square plus 6x, and that will be the answer. To write in a standard form, we will write first like 8x cube plus 12x square plus 6x plus 1. If you write it like this also, there is no problem. Now the second question in this section is, let me write second question. And the second question was there 2a minus 3b whole cube. 2a minus 3b whole cube that we have to calculate. So we know that a minus b whole cube. A minus b whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. So use the same thing here. And therefore, we can write it. 2a minus 3b whole cube is equal to 2a whole cube minus 3b whole cube minus 3 times of a. A is 2a and b is 3b and a minus b, that is 2a minus 3b. So if you go ahead with this, this will be 8a cube minus 27b cube minus 3 to ja 6, 6, 3 ja 18, 18ab. And 2a minus 3b. Now if you multiply by 18ab, this will comes like 8a cube minus 27b cube, 18 to ja 36a square b minus minus plus, 18 3 ja 54ab square, and that will be answer. You can write it like this. There is no problem. Right? The next one is, the third one is there. And the third one is here, like it is given that 3 by 2x plus 1 whole cube. So again, we will use the same concept and we will write here 3 by 2 x whole cube plus 1 whole cube plus 3 into 3 by 2 x into 1 into in bracket 3 by 2 x plus 1. This is what. So we will write 3 cube is 27 upon 8 x cube. 1 cube is 1. 3 3 is 9 by 2 x into 3 by 2 x plus 1. So if you multiply the same, you will have 27 by 8 x cube plus 1 plus 9 3 is 27 x square, you know, upon 2 to the 4 x into x, x square. So x square has been written already. And now 9 by 2 x. This is x term. 9 by 2 into x plus 1 is 9 by 2 x. You can write it. You can write it. 1 can be taken as last because it is a constant term, and then that will be in the standard form of polynomial. But if you not do, there is no problem at all. Now the next question is here, the question part 4 of this one. Part 4 is there, x minus 2 by 3 y whole cube. Again you will go with the same process, x cube minus 2 by 3 y whole cube minus 3 into x into 2 by 3 y into in bracket x minus 2 by 3 y. So that will come up x cube minus 8 by 27 y cube, 3 3 cancel, minus 2 x y into x minus 2 by 3 y. So it will become like x cube upon 8 by 27 y cube, 2 x y minus x, that is 2 x square y, minus minus plus 2 to the 4 upon 3 x y square, and that will be the answer. So it's not a big deal. I think you can do it nicely. Once you remember the formula, then there is no problem at all. You can do that. Now next question is there. Evaluate the following using suitable identity. Evaluate the following using suitable identity. Suitable identities. Identities. Right? So, what is the question? First one is 99Q. Of course, you know that how to deal with. That can be written as 100 minus 1 whole cube. Let me write in next step because it is a question. So 99 cube can be written as 100 minus 1 whole cube. Using the formula A minus B whole cube, what will happen? This will be equal to 100 cube minus 1 cube minus 3 into 100 into 1 into 100 minus 1. This is what, using the formula A minus B whole cube. So what will happen here? That will be 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 minus 1 minus 300 into 100 minus 1. Or even you write 100 minus 1 is 99. So we can do that. So using the same concept, you will have here 60 minus 1 minus 3, 40 and plus 300. So that will be positive 1 will be 1 0 0 0 0 plus 300. So it will be 30 and 300 minus 30 0 0 1, that you have to subtract. And finally what will come? 9. And this there will be 9 again. Right now, this is 2 again and 0. If you need to subtract from here, 0, that is 0, and 3. If I would subtract from here, that will be 7, and that will be 9. So 9, 7, 0, 2, 3, 3. I hope you got it. Similarly, there is another question, part 2 is 102 whole cube. What is the formula has been used here? That A minus B whole cube. You know that 100 plus 2 whole cube. Again, you can do that. So 100 plus 2 whole cube. you can write it, and you can write it again 100 square q plus 2 q plus 3 into 100 into 2 into 100 plus 2. So we can do that. This is 60 again plus 8 plus 3 to just 600 multiply by 100 plus 2. I am writing a step by step. So you will write here that that will be 10 20 30 40 50 60. 60 plus 8 plus 6 into 100 is 60,000, right now, and plus 1200. So if you add them, then what will come? This will be 80 and 10 61208, and that will be answered. So like that you can do that. And third part of the question is given here, that is question number 998 whole cube. That further can be written as 1000 minus 2 whole cube, and this is written minus 2 whole cube minus 3 into 1000 into 2 into 1000 minus 2. So that will be 30 cube will be 90. So that will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 90 minus 8 minus 3 to just 6000. Right now, 6000 multiplied by 1000 is 6000 multiplied by 1000. 3 more 0 will come, and 6000 multiplied by minus 2, that will be plus 12000. Right now, 12000. And total sum, if you will add them, 994 and 011, and this is 992, and that will be answered. I hope you got it. We'll do that, because first you will add these two and then subtract these two. You will be able to do that. Now the next question is question number 7, and the 7 is 7 was this, that is question number 8. And 8 is given, factorize each of the following. Factorize each of the following. Each of the following. Right? Factorize each of the following. Somewhere it is written by yes, somewhere it is written by z. Both are correct. You can use it s in British language. So factorize each of the following. And this one question is given, the very first question is given like here, that 8aq plus bq plus 12a square b plus 6ab square. So this is in form of here 2a whole cube plus bq plus 3a square, that is 2a whole square into b plus 3 2a into b whole square. So this is in form of, this is in form of, since aq plus bq plus 3a square b plus 3ab, a plus b whole cube, and therefore we can write it 2a plus b whole cube. That will be 2a plus b whole cube. Therefore this can be written as 2a plus b whole cube, and that will be the answer. 3, that is the factors. Now second part of the question is given like, second part of the question is given that 8aq minus bq minus 12a square b plus 6ab square. Obviously here the second term is negative. If you will do the same thing here, it will be b plus 3 into 2a into b square. This is nothing else but 2a minus b whole cube. I hope you got it. Now the third part of this one is given here, that third part of the question is given like, let me explain this. Third one is given and this, that is 27 minus 125 aq minus 135 a plus 225 a square. That is nothing else but same thing, 3q minus 5aq minus 3 into a square, that is 3 into b, that is 5a, plus 3ab square. A is 3 and b is 5a whole square. This is the rearrangement, and here therefore this can be written as 3 minus 5a whole cube, and that is an answer. So this is in pattern of which one? You will write the formula just for reference. You can write it since a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square is equal to a minus b whole cube. So that is why I have written like this. So you can go ahead with this and you will refer the formula. There is no issue about it. So now the question number 4 is there. And fourth question is 64a cube minus 27b cube minus 144a square b plus 108ab square. That is again the same thing. This is 4a whole cube. We can rearrange them. That is 3b whole cube minus 3 into 4a whole square into 3b plus 3 into 4a into 3b square. That is, see, 9, 9 into 4, 9 4 ja, 36 into 3 108. So this is just a rearrangement, nothing else. Even a child can do this, right? Now? So this is a minus b whole cube. And the fifth one is there also. One more question is there. That is 27 PQ minus 1.216 minus 9 by 2 P square plus 1 by 4 P. If you rearrange them again in a similar way, you can write this is 3 P whole cube and this is 1 by 6 whole square. So that is 3 P minus 1 by 6 whole cube. You can rearrange and you can write answer. Do it alone. This is not difficult at all. Question number 9. I am looking for question number 9 now. Question number 9 is there, and 9 is verify x cube plus y cube is equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. This is the first one. And the second one is x cube minus y cube is equal to x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. These are two formula, but anyway, because it has to be verified, so we can proceed from RHS. And for first one, x plus y we can write it x plus y. RHS of first one is x plus y, x square minus xy square. If you multiply by x with this one, x square minus xy plus y square plus y times of this x square minus xy plus y square. Then what will happen? If you multiply this, then that will be x cube minus x square y plus xy square plus here x multiply x square y minus xy square plus y cube. Here if you will observe this, then x square y is negative, here x square y is positive, here xy square is positive, here xy square is negative, and then what is left? There is x cube plus y cube. This is the LHS, which is the proof. Now for second, similarly for second one, it is given x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. So again we can proceed in the same way that this can be written as x into x square plus xy plus y square minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. And here what will happen? X multiply by x square is x cube plus x square y plus xy square minus x square y minus xy square minus y cube. Again, you will see here that x square plus y is positive, x square plus y is negative. These two are positive and negative, so that will be cancels. And what is left now? That is x cube minus y cube. and that will be the answer. So hopefully you got all these things that how to deal with some situations and same multiplications. It is not a big deal for you. Now there is a question number 10. Let me write this question. 10. Factorize each of the following. Factorize each of the following. Each of the following. Each of the following. Right. This is what the question given here. And the first question is given here like 10. 27 y cube plus 125 z cube. So you can use it the same thing, that is x cube plus y cube. This is 3y whole square, 3y whole cube and 5z whole cube. A cube plus b cube, formula is a plus b into a square minus ab, 3y whole square minus 3y into 5z plus 5z whole square. So this is the formula which I have used here. 3y plus 5z, that is z. So this one is z. 5z into, that will be 9y square minus 5, 3 is 15yz plus 25z square, and that will be the answer of this question. So we can factorize it by using the formula that here. What is the formula I have used here? Similarly, second part of this is given here, that in question number 10, 64m cube minus 343n cube. That is nothing else but 4m ka whole cube minus 7n whole cube. A cube minus b cube. Again, you can write the formula that this will be equal to a minus b, that we can be written as a minus b. It means 4m minus 3n into a square means 16m square plus ab, that is 7, 4 is 28mn plus b square, that is 49n square. Again, the same process, you can write it and that will be the answer. A cube minus b cube. The formula has been used here. Factorization method. Number 11. What is 11? Factorize 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. We know that a cube minus b cube, a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square, b minus bc minus c. So using the same fact here also, we can have 27x cube, therefore 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz can be written as 3x whole cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3 into 3x into y into z, isn't it? And therefore, because this is in this pattern, so RHS will be the answer. So that is why we can write it like a plus b plus c. A plus b plus c, it means 3x plus y plus z, and that will be a square plus b square plus c square. 3x whole square is 9x square plus y square plus z square minus 3x into y, that is 3xy, bc, that is yz, and ac, that is 3x into z, 3xz, and that will be the answer of this question. So I hope you got it. That is 3x. Let me write here. Okay. Now this one is question number 11. Now question number 12 is there, and let me write question number 12, that verify that x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz minus 3xyz is equal to half of x plus y plus z into x minus y whole square plus y minus z whole square plus z minus x whole square. So starting from RHS, we can start from RHS, and what will happen? You will write it RHS is 1 by 2 x plus y plus z, and what is that? X minus y whole square is x square minus 2xy plus y square plus y square minus 2xyz plus, and z minus x whole square is z square minus 2xz plus x square. So it all will come like 1 by 2 x plus y plus z into x square here, that will be 2x square, y square there and y square here also. So y square plus y square is 2y square, z square plus z square is 2z square, and minus 2xy minus 2yz and minus 2xz, that is given. Now if I took 2 common, then this 2 and 2 will be cancelled out, and what is left? X plus y plus z, and that will left here if I have 2 have been taken common. So x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx, and you know this is the formula of a cube plus b cube plus c cube, which is equal to x cube plus y cube, and this is LHS, and that is the proof. I hope you got it. For question number 13, and what is that? It is written that if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, so that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. So solution will be there. We know x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus. Now since a plus b plus c is equal to 0, and therefore x cube, 0 multiply everything is 0. So x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, and this employee x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. Good. So this is question number 13, because 0 multiply by everything is 0. And now question number 14. So we are looking for question number 14. Without actually calculating the cubes, the cubes, find the value of each of the following. The first part of this is here given. The first part is minus 12 whole cube plus 7 whole cube, minus 12 whole cube minus 7 whole cube and plus 5 cube. If I put x is equal to, a is equal to minus 12, b is equal to 7 and c is equal to 5, then a plus b plus c is equal to 0, and therefore a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc, right? So therefore put the value of abc here, and hence that will be minus 12 whole cube plus 7 whole cube plus 5 whole cube is equal to 3 times of minus 12, 7 and 5. 15, 15 into 12 is 180, so minus 180 into 7 is 1260. That will be answer. Okay, so I hope you got it. Now the second one is a similar like 28 whole cube. Again, 28 whole cube plus minus 15 whole cube plus minus 13 whole cube. Again, you will do the same process. Put a is equal to, if we put a is equal to 28, b is equal to minus 15, c is equal to minus 13, then a plus b plus c plus b plus c is equal to 28 minus 15 minus 13 is equal to 0. And therefore, a cube plus is equal to 3abc. And hence, we can write 28 cube plus minus 15 cube plus minus 13 cube is equal to 3 times of 28 into minus 13 as well. So minus minus plus, and 28 3 is 84. So that will be 84 multiplied by 15 into 3 is 15 into 13 will be 15 into 13 is 195, and 195 into 84 is 16,380, and that will be answer of this question. So I hope you got it. Okay. Now question number 15 is there, and this is, let me write here. Question number 15 is there. Give the possible expression of the length and breadth. Give the possible expressions for the length and breadth. For the length and breadth of each of the following. Each of the following rectangles in which their areas are given, and the first part is given that area is 525a square minus 35a plus 12. So area is length into breadth, isn't it? So we can find it. Area is nothing else but length into breadth of, and so we have to split in these two factors. 25 into 12 is 300. So 300, how it will, can we break 25 into 15? So middle term is split, that is 20a minus 15a plus 12. And if I took 5a common, that will be 5a minus 4. If I take 3 common, that will be 5a minus 4. So 5a minus 3 and 5a minus 4. One of them is length, another of them is called breadth. So if length is 5a minus 3, breadth is 5a minus 4. If length is 5a minus 4, breadth is 5a minus 3. You can do it anyway. Right now? So you may write vice versa. So length, therefore, you will write here, length and breadth are respectively 5a minus 3 and 5a minus 4, or vice versa. Right? So like this. Now the second part of this question, similar question, is what? See, the second part of the similar question is given, area is equal to 35y square plus 13y minus 12. So again the similar situation, you will write length into breadth is equal to 35 into 12 is what? 35 into 12. That will come up 12 5 just 60. 35 into 12. 12 5 just 60 and 12 3 just 36 and 6 42, 420. So we have to write 420 and that will be negated. So it will be factor like negative. So one of them definitely will be more than 13 and another will be less than 13. One of them is positive and another of them is negative. So if I am taking here that 30 into, this is 30 into what, 14. 14 into 30, then this will be 340, but their sum or difference is not equal to 13. So any other factors like that is 7 into 2 into 15 into 2. So if I am looking for this 7 into 2, 14, 14 into 2, 28, 28 into 15, if I break, then their difference is 13. So we can write it 35y square plus 28y minus 15y minus 12. So we can write here, what is common can be taken, 7y can be taken. So 5y plus 7 4 is 28. And if I took here 3 common, then that will be, this is minus 12. They will be take y, and because sign, negative sign is taken, so inside this will be positive sign. And now we can take 5y plus 4y minus 3. So one of them is length and breadth, other is breadth. So therefore length and breadth are, length and breadth are what? 5y plus 4 and 7y minus 3 respectively, or vice versa. That is, other one is length and another one is breadth, or vice versa. Right? So these two are questions. Now one more question is left, and that I am going to discuss here today. That is question number 16. So let me write this question number 16. And what is that? What are the possible expression? What are the possible expression? Expression. What are the possible expression for the dimension? For the dimension. Dimension of the cuboids. Of the cuboids. Cuboid. Whose volumes are given as. Whose volumes are given as. Volumes are given as. First part of this question is like here, given that volume is 3x square minus 12x. So we know volume is nothing else but LVH. And if I took 3x common, then that will be x minus 4. So length, breadth and height are 3x and therefore length, breadth and height are what we can say, length, and therefore dimensions are, dimensions, any one of them can be length and breadth, dimensions are 3x and x minus 4. Answer, you can write it. Now the next question is, volume is given, any one of them can be length, other is breadth and third one is height. So again volume is given that 12 ky square minus plus 8 ky minus 20 k, it is given. So in that case, if I will take k common, again the same thing, that LBH will be there, and LBH is equal to this. So if I will take, what is common, 4k is common. So 4k, if I will take common, then what will happen? 3y square, isn't it? 4k, if I will take common, then 3y square and what is left here? That is 2y. And what is left here? Minus 5. 5, 3 is 15. Right now. So again, we can have a factor like 4k, and this will be 3y square plus 5y minus 3y minus 5. Can I write like this? Okay. Now I can write it 4k, and this, if I take y common, then 3y plus 5. If 1 is taken common, then y 3y plus 5. So it will be like 4k into y into 3y plus 5. These are the factors. 4y minus 1 and 3y plus 5. So that will be their possible dimension are 7 dimensions. Dimensions are possible dimensions are 4k, y minus 1, and 3y plus 5. Or k 4 times of y minus 1 and 3y plus 5. Therefore, these are possibility, and I hope you got it. 4 can be taken with the first factor or second factor or third factor. So these are the 4 possibility, and you got this. This is all about this topic, and hopefully you have enjoyed this. There are a lot of things which you have to learn, and now you are confident that you can solve any question from this topic. So keep watching, and also share with your friends. Subscribe this channel, and if there is any doubt, solve now booklet, and if there is any doubt, you may ask. Right now, booklet has been given to you. You can solve them, and if there is any doubt, you must ask me.